Hello students, welcome to the next topic in the DSP. The title for today's topic, that is nothing but linear convolution by using circular convolution. This is very important topic as far as the exam point of view considered, as well as this is the topic which will be mostly correlated with the concept called as aliasing. Now we will see how to calculate this linear convolution by using the circular convolution. Let's say for example we are proceeding with x of n, one of the sequence with the values 4, minus 3, 2 and 1, and h of n, or rather I will go for here the value, let's say y of n, 1, 0, 2. So these are the two values with us for which we want to calculate the linear convolution, but by using the circular convolution. So the things here are quite simpler to understand. If we want to find out, let's say, the convolution between these two sequences, this x of n will have the total number of samples, that is 4, and y of n will have the total number of samples, that is 3. So 4 plus 3 minus 1, that is nothing but the value of n which we need to use for calculating the circular convolution. This is very simple one. The logic is quite correlated with the impulse response of any filter, or this is quite correlated with the linear convolution concept. So sample values, total samples in the first sequence, total samples in the second sequence minus 1, so as to get the total number of samples in the resultant sequence. So based on this value 6, we are going to calculate the linear convolution, but by using the circular convolution. In short, it means that these sample values are differing over here, but we need to determine the value of capital N based on which the aliasing will not occur. Now we will see how to go for this 6-point circular convolution. Now we are going for the 6-point circular convolution. As we have seen in the earlier cases, if I want to, let's say, convert this 4 into 6, then I need to append the zeros. So here what I will do is simple task, I will just append the zeros, 2 zeros for this x1 and 3 zeros for, let's say, y of n, so as to have the reflection in the total 6-point circular convolution. So let's see the first circle which we will just point out here. This is what the first circle. Now I want here total 6 values, so I will just write down, divide this circle in total 6 values. So 1 2 3 4 5 6. Now the inner circle I will just maintain it for, let's say, x of n. So this is nothing but x of 0, that is 4, this is minus 3, this is 2, this is 1, and append 2 zeros. So these are the appended values which right now we can observe here. Okay, so as to convert it into the 6-point circular convolution. Now once the values are appended, now the task begins over here. Now what is the task? The task is quite simpler. Just provide the outer circle. This outer circle will do the job of y of n. So firstly, the y of n will be written for the folded values. So this will be nothing but the y of 0. This point, let me just correlate with this point so that I can do the multiplication operation in an easier way. This point is nothing but 0, this point is 2, this point, then this point and this point. These are the 3 zeros which we need to append so that this y of n will be converted into the 6 sample values. Now once we got this 3 appended zeros, now it is quite equalized with the approach of total 6-point circular convolution calculation. Now let's proceed for this x3 of 0 calculation for this specific case. So inner circle will be the fixed one, that is the circle for let's say x of n, and this outer one, that is nothing but for y of n. Now let's calculate it. So 1 into 4, I will just start from this point, so that is 4 plus this is minus 3 into 0, this is 0, plus 2 into 0, 0, plus 1 into 0, that is 0, plus 2 into 0, so everywhere it will be 0. So x3 of 0 will be nothing but the value 4. So this is what x3 of 0. Now we need to calculate the next, that is nothing but x3 of 1. So for this, calculating the x3 of 1, we just need to shift this y of n by one position. It means after shifting this value, this will become 1, this will become 0, this will become 2, and this will be 0, this is 0, 0. Okay, so this is nothing but simply the next calculation for x3 of 1. Inner circle will not be disturbed at all. Now let's calculate it for x3 of 1. This is nothing but minus 3, this is 0, this is 0, this one is also 0, this is also 0, and next is also 0. So this is how x3 of 1 will be nothing but minus 3. Now the same signal is further delayed by 1, so this will be 1. Now this is 2, sorry, this is 0, and this one will be 2. This is 0, 0, 0. Now let's calculate it for x3 of 2. So for x3 of 2, this is 2 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 8 plus 0. So it means it is the value 10. So x3 of 10, x3 of 2 is nothing but the value 10. Now let's proceed for the next values. So for x3 of 3, we are at this particular shift. So this will be replaced by 1, this will be 0, this will be 2, this is 0, this is 0, and 0. So let's multiply it. So x3 of 3 will be equal to 1 plus 0 minus 6. Okay, let me write it here directly. Minus 6. So minus 3 into 2, 6. Then next 0, 0. Okay. So 1 minus 6 means it is minus 5, which is the value for x3 of 3. Next time, the values which we need is again shift it. So this will be 1, this is 0, this is 2, this one will be 0, this is 0, and 0. This is how the delayed values will be calculated. So x3 of 4, that will result in a next values. So let's say it is 1 into 0, that is 0, plus 2 into 2, that is 4, plus minus 3 into 0, that is 0, plus 4 into 0, that is 0, plus 0. So this is how x3 of 4 will be 4. Now the final value, that is x3 of 5. So this is the final shift. So for the final shift, let me just provide it in a clear way. So this is 1, this is 0, this will be 2, this will be 0, appended 0, this 0, and this 0 as it is. So x3 of 5, this is 0, 0 into 0, then 2 into 1, this is 2, plus 0 into 2, 0, this 0, 4 into 0, so everywhere it is 0. So this will result in a value 2. This is how x3 is ranging from 0 to 5. So let me write it x3 of m, since it is 0 to n minus 1, so the final value for x3 can be summarized as a 4 minus 3, then 10 minus 5, 4 and 2. So this is nothing but the simple calculation of linear convolution by using the circular convolution. This is decided based on the sample values of each sequence minus 1, so as to get the figure which is required to decide the capital N. Based on this capital N, we are performing this circular convolution. Now the thing is, if someone proceed with, let's say, 4-point circular convolution, so he need to append only 1 0 for y of n, but this 4-point circular convolution will result in only 4 values. It means the overall the values which we expect is 6 values, and if someone is getting only 4 values, it means 2 values are being overlapped with each other in order to result only as is 4 total resultant value. So this is nothing but actually the effect called as a aliasing, but in order to avoid the aliasing, we need to proceed with this kind of value, that is 6. So that is all about the linear convolution by using circular convolution. So thank you everyone, thank you very much.